It's Sunday, and you know what that means. Time to pull out our planners, and we're gonna go through and meal prep for It's Sunday. That means it's another meal plan day. So I've got my planner ready to go. Got a couple pens, got a purple one this time. I can't wait to show you guys how we did last week to see, did we stick with the meal plan? If not, what was changed? What happened? Did I have to go to the grocery store again? And then what are we gonna eat for this week? Plus a look ahead to Thanksgiving. So if you want a meal plan too, just stick around and keep watching because I'm gonna show you my exact process. You can watch me meal plan in real time on this episode of Meal Plan With Me. So if you've been following me on Instagram, you know that I have been trying this meal planning thing all over again. I used to do it all the time when I just had one kid. Now I have three and it's been a struggle to do it. So all this month of November, I have been trying to meal plan. And I did this really big shopping trip at the very end of October. The last week of October, I went to like two stores. Since then, I have done some online ordering. And curbside pickups. I had to get a few little things. But now we're in week three of November. I have been consistent at meal planning. I'm very proud of myself. So let's jump right into it. Here's the meal plan from last week. And as you can see, it has a lot of markings on it. We had to make a lot of changes starting with Monday. So for lunch, we ended up eating the soul food that we had left over from Sunday. But then for dinner, I actually wasn't feeling too great on Monday. So I had my husband cook and the gyros were a pretty simple and quick recipe. So we swapped that out for the cheesy broccoli chicken and rice casserole. But then on top of that, when my husband was making the gyros, he saw that the pita bread that I got for it had went bad. Perfect, right? Sometimes your plans don't work out. It's fine. So what happened was it actually turned out to be a really wonderful thing that the pita bread was bad because we had a salad. So we just didn't have the pita bread and it was the most amazing meal ever. It tasted really, really good. It was really healthy. Then for Tuesday, we had the chicken broccoli chicken and rice casserole. We actually didn't have any of that left over, so we didn't have any of that any other day of the week. Now for Wednesday, we didn't have any sandwiches. I ended up making hot dogs for lunch, and then we had the leftover chimichurri soup. Throwback Thursday, we just scratched all that out. We just went to Chick-fil-A. Went to good old Chick-fil-A for lunch, and then for dinner, I pulled this recipe from out of this meal bank here. And we had that for dinner, the pesto rotini with cherry tomatoes. This is a hit. This is actually a frozen meal from Target. This is actually a hit in our house. This is actually a frozen meal from Target. We get about six bags, and six bags of these is about two servings for our family. It tastes so good. And then for Friday, we had leftovers from lunch, a little bit of leftover of this pesto rotini. We had that for lunch. And it was movie night, so we did have our pizza. And then when Simple Saturday came around, we went out again. We had some errands to run, so we just went and grabbed some Wendy's for lunch. And then today is Soul Food Sunday. This is today. We did have pancakes, bacon, and eggs. That was the meal that we had. And up on my Instagram page, I made a reel showing how I made the tallest pumpkin pancake stack. Ever. Okay, ever for me. It was the tallest I've ever made. So head on over to my Instagram. I'll put the link down in the description. You can go check it out. And it actually has a quite funny ending. Tonight, we're going to have some soul food again. So that was last week. Now, let's meal plan for this week. So I still have a bunch of options here that we can use for meals. So this is perfect. We're pretty much going to eat all these. So it really makes meal planning for this coming week a breeze. So that's why I really suggest, like, if you're going to get into meal planning, try to think of all the meals that your family really enjoys. And also think of not even just meals that you have to make from scratch, but meals that you can just prepare from like frozen food and things like that. Now be careful because frozen foods and canned goods and things like that do have a lot of preservatives. A lot of times they are, you know, in salt for storage, for preservation. So you want to be careful and make sure you read the labels when you get these things. Okay, so one thing I forgot to tell you guys is something about my mom planner. So I did put information in my description in the last video, and I'll put some more information in this video. But this is actually a happy planner that you cannot buy anymore because it's kind of like a hybrid, or I don't know what you want to call it. This is a cover from a mom life planner that I had, but all the inserts are like from a teacher planner. I've got some, you know, all kinds of sheets from other things. So you can't exactly buy this, but you can buy other types and have really great designs out there. But I'm gonna open up my planner now and we're gonna go over to this week. Here is my weekly meal planning sheet here, insert. Now this is something that you can still buy and you don't have to put it in a happy planner. You can put this in any planner that you desire because the pages just kind of pop in and out. I love this sheet. It makes it so great for planning. I've already got it set up for this week with the date so that I know, and more information on where to buy this is in the description. So meal planning this week should be a breeze. I pretty much need to figure out where I want to put these things on here. So I think that let's start with the breakfast. Breakfast is always easy. And to be honest, I'm just going to leave it like just exactly like this, except for we don't have any more yogurt. So I'm not going to do that, but I'm just going to copy the same thing. That was easy. That was breakfast. Now let's do lunch and dinner. So I know that tomorrow we'll probably have leftover soul food from today, because they always give you so much food to last multiple meals. You should never eat that at one time. It's just a lot of food when you get soul food. And then let's see, we'll do, we'll have like lunch meat sandwiches. So I'll put lunch meat, this will be like a sandwich day, lunch meat or grilled cheese sandwiches for Tuesday. And then Wednesday we'll do, let's see, SpaghettiOs and fruit, because I do remember I was trying to I think I had that on the meal for, yeah, I had that here, SpaghettiOs and fruit, but instead we went to Wendy's. So I'm gonna put that for lunch for Wednesday. So SpaghettiOs and fruit will be for lunch on Wednesday. And then Thursday, for Throwback Thursday, we'll have leftovers, sandwiches. I will leave room, I'll put TO for takeout, to order out, you know, fast food or something. We don't want to do that all the time. And not every fast food place we go to is like, you know, a Wendy's or Chick-fil-A where they have fried things. There are many other places around here where we get other types of foods like salads and wraps, smoothies and things like that, so don't worry. Friday, for Pizza Friday, last time we had leftovers, we ended up eating leftovers. I'm gonna put the same thing, leftovers or sandwiches. If we have anything left over from dinner, then we'll just, you know, have that or have a sandwich. And then to the weekend, so for Simple Saturday, we ate out because we were running errands on last Saturday. So, you know, that might happen again. But for now, I'm just going to put grilled cheese because I've been really wanting to make those. I don't know what it is about a grilled cheese sandwich. It's so comforting. I really love them with tomato and they taste really good with tomato soup. And then for Sunday, which is like our soul food Sunday, but also kind of, you know, leisure resting, we usually have a late brunch type of thing. So we'll just have sandwiches. I know it's like sandwich, 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 but I'm telling you, I'm trying to gear up for the holiday season. It's the end of the month. I'm really not trying to be cooking like that. And I really just want to try to eat what we have at home. I'm really trying to challenge myself to just be content with what we have and just eat what's in the house. So this is what we have in the house. This is what we're gonna eat. All right, that is done. Now let's do dinner. So we have a whole bank here. Let's see. What can we do? So because our Monday has a kind of heavy breakfast, kind of heavy lunch, kind of want to lighten it up a little bit. I do want to get this baked potato in. We haven't had them yet, any of our baked potatoes. So I think we'll have the cinnamon baked potatoes. And let's see, we'll have it to go with, maybe these Philly cheesesteak bao buns. They are really good. They're from Trader Joe's in the frozen section. They are so yummy. You've got to get some. They're so good. Probably tastes really good with some sriracha ketchup or something like that. So I'm going to put that here. Philly cheesesteak bao buns plus the baked cinnamon sweet potatoes. I'm excited about that. Oh, with asparagus, because it's with, I gotta check my asparagus and see if it's still good. Because I bought it like last week or the week before. I've had it for a little while, so I don't know. But yeah, I'll probably put the asparagus with it. So, you know, that's a little bit not as heavy of a meal. Okay, so Tuesday we're having cereal and then sandwiches. So we can have a little bit, you know, a little bit more substance or something. So I'm thinking, let me check this off. So we got our baked potatoes here. And we got the bao buns. I think this chicken parm would be good for this day. Chicken parm. You know what? And this is all with ingredients from Trader Joe's that I'm going to be putting together. So it's really, really not from scratch. I'm just putting things together and they have some amazing ingredients so I can make a chicken parmesan. Let me know if you want more information on some of like how I put some of these things together, the recipes for some of these things, because not everything I make is from scratch. I kind of grab this and that from here and there and kind of put things together. So if you'd like to see a recipe like for the chicken parmesan or, anything else that we're going to put on here, leave me a comment. And I will, I'll make that happen for you. I've been wanting to eat like Chinese food, Asian food for the longest time. And we really, really love this orange chicken from Trader Joe's. So I think Wednesday is the perfect day for that. So I'm going to put orange chicken. It's from Trader Joe's. It's in their frozen food. So it's so good and the kids love it. Pair that up with their fried rice that they have. Also in the frozen food section, like right next to the orange chicken. Y'all have to get this. So good, y'all. It's so, so good. And it's a veggie fried rice that I have. All right, moving along. Throwback Thursdays, usually when we have leftovers. I don't know that we'll have any leftovers from a lot of these things that we're having. I mean, we might have leftovers here because I bought extra. So we might have some here, but I'm not totally sure. So just in case there's no leftovers, I will put down instead, oh, this barbecue meatballs and rice. This has been on our meal plan every week and I have yet to make it. So barbecue meatballs and rice. Now I am half Filipina. So when I say rice, if it's just rice like that, just rice, not fried rice. It's just rice. That means just regular old white jasmine rice. Okay, sticky jasmine rice. Cause listen, steamed. I'm so Filipino. Don't put no nothing in it. Just steam it up with some water and you good to go. So that's what I mean by rice. Okay, Friday. Oh, that's easy. That's our family movie night. We're gonna actually turn that into a family fun night. We won't always watch a movie, but we will probably always have a pizza. And we do still have some more frozen pizzas. Now, Saturday is Simple Saturday. Last time we had hot dogs and beans. I think this week will be a good time. Let me cross off some of these things to have the burgers and sweet potato fries. Just something that's like comforting and, warm and I don't know. So burgers and sweet potato fries. Again, this is from Trader Joe's. I'm literally just putting these things together to make these things. And then Sunday, we usually do our soul food Sunday. But because Thanksgiving is coming up the following week, I don't want to keep spending money on soul food because it can get very pricey when you have to feed five people. But what we typically do with the kids is our two youngest girls, they kind of count as one person and they just split the food. But my seven-year-old, he definitely like doesn't need to share with anyone. He eats just as much. He eats like a teenager. So I think we'll just add this last thing here, which is the dumplings and egg rolls. And I know that may not seem like it's a lot, but I'm gonna add some more rice to it. So what I'll do is when I make the rice here on Thursday, I'll make a large pot of rice. That rice will last us for Sunday. And we'll have, let's see, it is dumplings. And again, this is from Trader Joe's. And I'm telling you, these dumplings, they are so amazing. And the egg rolls too. They're just hits in our home, just hits. So, and rice, and really that should be enough. Having a late big brunch, brunch, then having a, you know, light lunch, this dumplings, egg rolls, and then the rice is, you know, like this will be good enough. So that was pretty easy. That was like a really simple meal plan for this week. So that's the meal plan for this week. Now, I'm gonna go type that up and I'll be right back. Okay, so here's the meal plan for next week. I've got a little bit of marking on it already, so I might print out a new one just because I've got makeup smudges and water stains. But anyway, this is the meal plan for next week. And as you can see, I've got it all typed up. Thanksgiving week is coming up. That means that I have to plan for Thanksgiving. So what I went ahead and did is I did a look ahead to Thanksgiving. I just kind of put down a few things that I think that we might want to have. I asked my kids, my husband, you know, what do you guys want to eat? And also just knowing how we like, you know, what we like. My husband actually had suggested a Filipino meal for Thanksgiving for this year. But we're actually going to do it for Christmas. Usually when we do the Filipino meals for the holidays, we tend to just keep them for Christmas time. And we have more like soul food and even seafood for Thanksgiving. I remember one year we did a seafood Thanksgiving. Like that's all we had was all kinds of seafood, fish, crabs. Like it was great being from Baltimore, Maryland. Like I love crabs. I did put them here. Now this is not set in stone. This is just a look ahead. This is just me thinking ahead of time because I'm going to have to go to the grocery store. And so we will see. But I put down ham because we got to have ham. We're not going to do a turkey this year, but I'm going to do some baked chicken, you know, for the kids, some crab legs. We got to have the mac and cheese, the cornbread. I love cabbage. So we're going to have some of that and then some string beans, probably. Got to get an apple pie. Might make one. I have a really amazing recipe that was handed down to me and apple cider. So this is just a look ahead. You got to stay tuned for next week to see if we actually keep this menu for Thanksgiving or not. But that's what we've got, and it's ready to go on the fridge. So did I end up having to go to the grocery store? Yes and no. I mean, I didn't really go to the grocery store. I did some online and curbside pickups because there were a couple household items that we ran out of and a couple grocery items that we really needed, like some cheese and things like that, that I didn't really account for previously. So we did run out of those things. I put in two orders last week at a couple of stores, and then that was it. I'm gonna have to do that again for this week because now I'm looking ahead for December, the winter's coming, and just kind of planning ahead with the changes because of COVID and things like that. So I do wanna stock up on like our vitamins. We need more baby wipes. We do need some more household things. I'm not going to be really buying a lot of food, but I will be getting more sparkling water. I'm trying to think what else is on my list. I'll just show you. So here's the master grocery list. You know what? I don't like this name. I'm going to change it to all out of, because we're all out of, and then, you know, that makes more sense to me. So the all out of list. So I have here ginger root because I did buy some veggies to make some juices and we're gonna need more ginger. I ran out of my favorite cinnamon tea from Target. We ran out of maple syrup today. We ran out of pancake mix today. If you go over to my Reels on Instagram, you'll see what we used instead of our normal pancake mix. The kids have run out of their snacks. I might add more things here. Their snack drawer is pretty much bare. And then I know I'm gonna be having ham for Thanksgiving. So I put this on my list for this week to get, because you definitely don't wanna wait till the week of Thanksgiving to get the ham or the turkey, because you know, they run out. Then all of the paper goods and household things that we have run out of. Now, a lot of these things that's on here, I put them here because I'm intending to go to Sam's Club as one of the places. They are a whole sale place that is local to me. And I saw that they have a lot of these things on sale. So I want to definitely get some of these things while they're on sale. As well as stocking up on our drinks. We are a big sparkling water family. We love sparkling water. So this is the shopping that I'm going to do this week. I'm going to do a curbside pickup at a couple places, probably Target, because again, they have my favorite cinnamon tea, and then Sam's Club. And then we'll see. I might make a trip over to Trader Joe's, and that'll be the only grocery store that I actually physically walk into this week, most likely. So that's it.
And so that's all there is to it. I've got the final meal plan right here in my hands. It's ready to go up there on the fridge. But I want you to let me know down in the comments, do you think we're gonna stick to this meal plan? Yay or nay? Inquiring minds want to know. I hope that you'll say yes. I hope that you think that we will stick to this. But then come back next week as I plan for Thanksgiving. I'm so excited for the holiday season. So come back and join me next week. Make sure you've got that notification on and that you subscribe so you won't miss a thing on the next episode of Meal Plan With Me.